Thank you so much. Annie Dillard wrote in her book, The Writing Life, how we spend our days is, of course, how we spend our lives. And though it sounds quite obvious, it hits on something that relates to why I've spent much of the last 6 years rummaging through trash and empty grocery carts. I went from occasionally noticing to passively collecting and finally actively soliciting the evidence of how members of my various communities spend their most precious resources of time. Note at 10:25, this writer is laying out stylish clothes, energy, and attention. Individually and collectively, we do a lot of stuff, or at least we aspire to. As you'll notice here at the bottom, this is front and back of the same very dense list. At the very bottom, it says, "Why don't I have time to read anymore?" Some people say if they don't write something down, they just won't remember to do it. Like it or not, our lists do reflect our priorities, even when they're still developing, like our frontal lobes. And though the details, the contents of our list may be specific to our age, our gender, our culture, our class, and no doubt many other factors, I do believe that the implications that we can read from them have fairly small c Catholic implications, such as I think we as humans are generous. We buy birthday presents between the Lysol and the half and half. We do want to be connected. We don't always live up to other people's expectations. All of us have physical needs to tend to, some of us with more brand loyalty than others. We have spiritual sides. And we feel very deeply. The first item on this gem in my collection says, "Get comfortable with the notion that he will never call." And the last three items, "Remember, suffering and change are certain, rearrange paradigm, and eat more ice cream." It's true, sometimes we procrastinate. But often we pursue our tasks with pinpoint focus worthy, I believe, of recognition, representation, recontextualization, and translation into other media. I believe this person might enjoy hiring or perhaps dating this person. Very organized, good communicator. Paradoxes abound in our lists, and I was hoping someone might explain to me fat-free half and half after the panel. I would like to nominate this person for the map-making job that Anne-Marie Slaughter advertised yesterday. Oh, and also I lost a blue scarf somewhere at the conference yesterday, and my dear Aunt Joan knit it for me, so if anybody's seen it, let me know. So my research has been utterly unscientific and entirely anecdotal, but it has been peer-reviewed. Viewers to my installations I tend to call Wall of Intention often laugh. They seem to identify with people they don't know. They commune with others through these intimate yet anonymous artifacts, reading them aloud to one another and sometimes themselves. There is a lot of merriment, but often there is a change of tone, as there is when viewers encounter this particular list that these young musicians viewed at the Interlochen Center of the Arts this summer. It was written by a graduate of the Maine College of Art who was preparing for his second tour of duty in Iraq. I don't know if you can make it out, it's faint, but it says, "Prepare for Iraq," in parentheses, "again. Pack my bags. Clean," which is crossed out, "organize and rent the house." So this project has helped me catapult myself and others through conversations, past small talk, to the meat of the matter, things such as fighting memory loss with strawberries, spinach, olive oil, liver, and the reasons that we want to do that for ourselves and our loved ones. We document the most joyous moments of our lives with lists such as the birth of a baby and the most challenging, such as the planning of a memorial service of a parent. So a few of the things that I've created in response to this amazing archive that's come my way, a portfolio of prints called Sticky Situations, a body of inlaid burnishing clay tablets. This one of a list remarkable to me in that it heads, starts off living within means, includes large picture items such as create community and pay off debt. So what's on our list and what should be on our list? Our lists show us indulging in a vice or two, sometimes five or six, and striving for more moderation or borderline aestheticism. Go dad! And I'll just close this out by saying that it's a real joy to be here 4 years ago. I was collecting these lists here in Midcoast, Maine. I was using these solicitation envelopes in which there was a temporary tattoo. They were given away inside venues, six or seven venues here, including Zoot Coffee down the street. They hosted vinyl decals. This project, which sought to turn the gallery inside out, bring the community to the gallery, bring the gallery to the community, was supported generously by Maine Arts Commission and Maine Humanities Council. And my introduction to PopTech came when I was by flashlight taking graphite rubbings of these decals on the front of Zoot Coffee at about 11:30 at night on a Thursday in October, and these remarkable people kept coming by and telling me about digital innovation in list making, and that's how I learned about PopTech. So I'll just finish off by inviting you. I'll be carrying this bag tonight. If anyone would like to stick a list in, I have some tattoos and some stickers for you. This one says, battery charging, please be patient. And if anyone anywhere else in the world would care to expand my archive, I would be most grateful. Thank you.